obviously, as it's no surprise, for about a year and a half, we all have been dealing with a situation that we don't know how to deal with, you know, the lockdown and the COVID. I recently recovered from COVID, so it's obviously been a little exhausting, but I feel like there's always a silver lining to things, and I am so excited because there's so much more music coming up in 2021, so many songs that we wrote in 2020 also. So I think it's going to be a very exciting year no matter what happens. I think music, especially, you know, the kind of stuff that new artists, a lot of, like, all of us are doing as musicians, is just giving more songs, releasing more songs. So I think as soon as we can start shooting, we're going to be shooting, because the songs are ready. We're just waiting to shoot the music videos right now. But yes, COVID and the entire lockdown has been a very introspective time for all of us. I've spent so much time with my own self, did face a little bit of a creative block as well, but I'm finally getting used to it. We're all getting used to it, you know, the whole work from home thing. But yes, looking forward, and we're all going to come out of this so enhanced and enriched, and, you know, so much more music coming up, so I'm so excited. Between Prakriti and Amriti, who I very fondly call Didi because she's also 9 years older than the two of us. You know, I feel like with Prakriti and I feel like we were born to work together. So it's such a natural flow of things, you know, it just happened so naturally. It's not like, you know, one day we woke up and we decided that we want to work together. It just happened because we always liked the same thing. We very naturally got into the same profession, started singing together, and there came a point where a lot of people would ask us, you know, you guys do the same thing, why don't you all have a song together? And that was the day, I think, in 2018, while we started singing in 2014, is after 4-5 years we decided that, you know, we need to have some songs together to be able to do this in the long run and just to generally have more fun. And I think that's when we decided to really sit down and start songwriting, and since then it's 2021, it's been non-stop. But when it comes to Didi, I love observing her work. I think my entire life, why I'm a singer today, is because I've seen her work around me and seen her work ethic, and there's so much that I learn from her on a daily basis. So you know, I feel like with her my working relationship is more as a student, where I'm actually kind of learning things at all times. So she's always teaching me things. So I mean, I think that's the working dynamic between all of us. So yeah, this is a very interesting question. One quality of Prakriti that I wish I had, there are a couple, because, you know, a lot of people ask us, and how does it work? You guys are born on the same day, almost look alike, almost sound the same, are you guys similar? Well, I would like to say that behavior-wise, you know, things that we would agree on, we are very similar. But when it comes to personalities, we can be very different. I feel like she's a little more chilled out. She's more, you know, when she's doing something very passionately, she has a tendency of getting lost, forgetting about time, forgetting where she is. I, on the other hand, I have this little bit of paranoia of getting things done, deadlines and things like that. And also something that Prakriti has, she really speaks her mind without filter. And I can be the diplomatic one. So I think I can, yeah, I kind of control that. So I would like to start answering this question by just saying that I somewhere don't understand and kind of dislike how music gets bifurcated these days. There's film music and there's non-film music. But you know, I feel like the lines are suddenly, I feel in this time of music, are, you know, slowly disappearing. So which is a great thing for budding musicians, for everybody who's affiliated with the music industry, because music is happening. But along with that, I feel like non-film music gets the same leverage, is on the same pedestal, so that's awesome. For me, yes, my last film song, now that I'm actually thinking about it, is in 2019, but I really believe that my responsibility as an artist, as a singer, as a musician, is to sing. And you know, as long as I'm able to do that, for as long as I want, I'm doing what I'm meant to do. And I feel like right now, in these digital times also, it doesn't matter where our music comes out. as long as you're singing and as long as you're releasing songs and you're consistent with your music, I think that's where it matters. And you know, there's an audience for everything now, and I feel really blessed to be singing at a time where people are actually interested in seeing the face behind your voice and your music. And I feel like I've been able to achieve that a little bit more after singing for movies for 4-5 years, then in 2019 finally showing my face and appearing in my music videos. And I would like to do that for as long as I want and as long as I can. But deciding between being a playback singer and doing my own singles, I really can't. It's like a choice that, you know, would you give me a choice between performing on stage or being in the studio? I really can't choose. So it's the same situation. It's a catch-22 for sure. Because I started with singing for actresses as a playback singer, and that's actually my first identity. So I would love to keep singing for movies till I can. And obviously, on the other hand, I just feel more of a singer, more of a musician, because I'm making my own music and songwriting. So now I feel full. What would I have been if I wasn't a singer is something that I really haven't even thought about in so many years now. So yeah, thank you for the question. You know, but I feel the first thing that I ever wanted to be, you know, when you're young and you're in school and you have to write these essays where they ask you your ambition, or just generally the first thing that you're interested in growing up, for me it was definitely aviation. Like, I always thought of myself as a pilot. While my sister would play with Barbie dolls, I would be playing with miniature planes. I in fact had a whole showcase. My dad would get me different airlines, you know, small miniature planes that I would play with. I would play video games with the airplane simulators. So that is something I really wanted to do. I really wanted to study. Yeah, I'm one of those nerds who really wanted to go to a university and study and all of that. But life had other plans, I guess. I started working too young. I was 15, 16 and I was on stage already. And that's when I felt great, you know. And the more I got into it was just like, it's a full-time job, so there's no escape. But I didn't even want an escape. I started enjoying it so much. And but one day I'll definitely fly. I'm okay with the simulator also, but I mean, I would love to be in the cockpit for once. So I think if I wasn't a singer, I'd be Captain Sukriti. I think all the songs that you work on, that you're creatively involved in from the beginning, have all their different stories. And there have been so many stories linked to all the songs that I've been a part of and I've performed in. But I feel that Hum Tum is that one song that was very unsatisfying actually to me when we actually started writing, because I was obsessed with wanting to do something different than I've done. And then we started working on this song Hum Tum, which is essentially like a Latin song with a hip-hop beat, and I just loved the whole concept because I felt like not too many people have really experimented in this zone. And also the song we started working on in the last lockdown, so I think it was so challenging because everything was on Zoom and everything was digital. We weren't meeting people physically, and I feel like it's always better when you meet people physically and are in the same environment and then can come up with something. But Hum Tum was that song that just wasn't happening, you know. I was not happy with the lyrics, I was not happy with how it was sounding. It took its own time. It all happened digitally, and I felt that, you know, the challenges is what made it so interesting and satisfying by the end of it. Because after that song was released, and my label always loved the song when I didn't like it, and I was like, I know there's something missing, and they really liked it. So I was like, I'm gonna take my time, I'm gonna get used to it, and when I love it, then we'll release it. And that finally happened. And you know, when the song came out, a lot of people enjoyed it. And the only thing that everybody said is, this is so different and this is one of your best. And that's not the kind of response that I was, you know, expecting. So that's what made it so interesting, challenging, and also taught me that I shouldn't put so much pressure on songs and let them just do what they have to. It's music, and you know, let people enjoy it when they hear it, and don't put too much pressure on a song. Okay, interesting question. Because you know, I think when we talk about collaborations in music, sky is the limit, right? I think music is only music, and good music only comes out of collaborations. Yes, I think one Indian artist that I would love to collaborate with, that I've been dying to sing with for a very long time now, has to be, number one is Pritam Da, because I feel like I've been waiting for an opportunity for singing something for him, because I would love to know what he chooses for me, and he's made and he's discovered so many amazing artists. The list is endless. So a film song for Pritam Da is definitely on my bucket list. And internationally, you know, we just had a song out with Dua Lipa, and not in a million years I would have thought that something like that can even happen. You know, you have dreams, then you have things that just happened. My dream would have been to meet her, you know, but I have a collaboration with her, so didn't see that one coming. But now, if we're really talking about bucket list things and anybody that I'd love to work with, then I think my answer would be Doja Cat. I think I'm obsessed with her music. I love her. And yeah, I think secretly I really would love to do that kind of music one day. What does my current playlist look like? You know, a lot of people will be so surprised to hear this, because I am that person who actually steals songs off people's playlists. It takes me a lot of time to sit down and make my own playlist. So whether it's my manager or it's my best friend, I will please tell them, give me a new playlist. And then I put their songs in my playlist and, you know, keep hearing it. I also find out so many songs from Instagram and all of these places. So I just pick up what I hear and then I add it to my playlist. But my playlist can be very confusing, because you know, it can start from Coke Studio, then it can go back to 90s, and then it can come back to US UK Top 40. So it really depends on my mood. I think when it comes to playlists, I can be pretty moody. So one song that describes Prakriti, very difficult, because I feel like she is a girl of so many moods and so many movies together, so this is going to be difficult. But I think there's one thing that I've always told Prakriti, that I feel that, you know, you're stuck in a modern world, but she's such an old soul. I think I always tell her that you're born in the wrong generation. So I think one song like that would be Shallow, A Star Is Born by Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper. And yeah, I think that describes her perfectly. She's stuck in this modern world, and it's also one of our favorite songs to sing together, so definitely Shallow. So you know, actually 2021 so far has been a very good year, I can say, for me and Prakriti. We started the year with Sona Lagta. Then I had a song with one of my favorite people, Rishi Rich. This one was Galat Ho Gaya. And very recently, that's been Levitating with Dua Lipa. So I feel like there's so much pressure right now to obviously release music, but in the given circumstances, it's very difficult. And I've also been taking a little break, because I feel like I'm not going to enjoy myself releasing music at a time where things are just so sensitive. I would not feel great about promoting something. But, you know, things are looking better, and I think by July latest, I want to release the next song. This one's going to be very special. We love it already, waiting to shoot. Yeah, I think July you're going to hear something. I'm very, very excited about this one. It's also a collaboration again. And then after that, there's another collaboration, and this one's a ballad. So, the July one is a girl anthem, something that I haven't done in very long, so I'm very excited because we're doing that again. And then later is gonna be a romantic one, something I've also been wanting to sing for a very long time. So these two tracks, I'm very excited that you'll definitely hear in 2021.